In chapter two, we're going to look at instantaneous rates of change and then see how that leads to a concept known as the derivative. We're going to start out in section 2.1 with instantaneous rates of change. So the idea is that we're going to look at a rate of change. We start with looking at an average rate of change. That answers the question, how did this function change over a certain period of time? An instantaneous rate of change is asking the question, how is this function changing at this very moment? So what is the average change over a certain period of time? What is the function doing at this specific moment? In example one, we're going to find the average rate of change. We're going to find the rate of change for this function from x equals 1 to x equals 3. The function is x squared plus 3x minus 2, and we're looking for how much change happened from x equals 1 to x equals 3. Let's figure out where the function is when x is equal to 1. We can do that by plugging in 1 into our function. So 1 squared plus 3 times 1 minus 2. And we get out a 2. When we plug in 3 into the function, 3 squared plus 3 times 3 minus 2, I believe you get out a 16. How much change is there? Well, the change went from 2 to 16. So that is what I'm looking at for a rate of change. So the total change went from 2 to 16. So the total change was a change of 14 units. Because we're trying to find the rate of change, well, the rate is over an average x value of how much? So the x value changed, we can see, by 2. Another way you can say that, it changed from 1 to 3. So the change was 2. That means on average, this function changed 7 units per unit of x value. So the change in y was 7 per x value increase of 1 on average. So the change in the y value was 7 for every x increase by 1. And that is the rate of change. So the rate of change over a certain interval is going to be how much did my y value change divided by how much did my x value change. So if we have two points, x1, y1, and x2, y2, then I can look at the differences in the y values and divide that by the differences in the x values. When you put this in function notation, y values are simply your outputs of your function. So the difference in the outputs of the function divided by the difference in the inputs of the function. Notice that this rate of change is really a slope. So that's what we're saying. If you drew a straight line, what would be the slope of that straight line? That's going to be the average amount of change in the function. The other thing we're going to look at is the idea of a difference quotient. So the difference quotient is just another way to write a rate of change. It's where I put my x1 as the value of x, and then my x2 has been changed from x to a little bit more than x, like an x plus h. And if that's the case, then we can write the rate of change as a difference quotient. So think of my previous example. We went from an x equals 1 to an x equals 3. We could have also said we want to start at x equals 1 and increase by a value of 2. So that 3 could have been thought of as just 1 plus 2. So x value here, x1 is my 1, and then my x plus h is just 2 more than 1. And if you do that, notice that the denominator in my rate of change is just the value we increased by. We increased by 2, so that's just my denominator. So the h is my denominator, and then the value in my numerator is still f of x, and then f of the new x. You might think that this difference quotient is sort of an arbitrary and unnecessary way to write things, but it turns out when we talk about instantaneous rates of change, we really like writing a rate of change as a difference quotient. And the reason we like that difference quotient is because of this easy denominator. It's a single value in my denominator that I can mess around with instead of having a difference of two values in my denominator. So when we go to instantaneous rates of change, it's very handy to talk about difference quotients rather than the rate of a change being the slope here, even though they're the same calculation. What I would like you to do now is find the rate of change for this function here from the x value of 4 to the x value of 7. Go ahead and push pause, do this, and then on the next video, I will solve that.